connection is unstable.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, I can hear you.
Okay.
There is some disturbance in between.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Actually, I have problem with my internet today. Is it okay if I off my video? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. I'm sorry, but there is a very serious internet issue. Okay. Good afternoon. I welcome you all to the second session of mine. And today we would be doing about PR, that is public relation and corporate communication. So, 1 minute. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Hope you, I'm audible. Am I audible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Can any one of the students answer me? Because
hello.
Yes, Charlotte.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. So I'll share the screen. Okay. Today I would be talking about PR and then corporate communication. And I don't want to repeat the general guidelines which was discussed earlier. And today's guidelines for PR is, if we look into the previous question papers, most of the questions are asked about definitions and then the role of public relations and then tools and techniques of PR and then structure of PR and ethics of PR. Okay, so I'll just randomly, I have again selected questions. So since you all were okay with the pattern, the first pattern of mine, development communication, I have just followed the same pattern here also. So initially, I would be discussing about the syllabus of PR and corporate communication. Again, this has been downloaded, and I hope you all know that syllabus has been already given by UGC NET board. So PR. It starts with public relation and corporate communication, and then definition, concepts, and then scope. So here in PR, if you see, there are a lot of terminologies that you have to know, because PR is, since it is publicity, and then it is in it is corporate communication, there are a lot of elements which is involved in it. So there are a lot of definitions also by different authors, different scholars. So as we did in development communication here also, we would be dealing with different definitions. And then from there, we are going to derive some questions. So basically, when you look into corporate communication deals with, okay, this simple question is also there. And then there are a lot of assertion and then reasoning questions if you look into the previous questions, question papers. And then you have a structure of PR in state, public, private, and then non-government sectors. So how this structure is being made in PR, in state and public, that is the government organizations, and private and then non-government sectors, that is NGOs and non-government sectors, how they make up their structures. And then you have tools and techniques of PR and corporate communication. And then you have crisis communication and crisis communication management. So there are certain things, there are certain techniques followed to tackle the crisis that arises in the industry. Okay, so what is that? Public relations is basically the relationship that you keep with the public. Okay, and this relation is very important because it is an organization and you have a product or you have a service to provide. Okay, so it becomes very important from the organization end to keep a very good relationship with the public, okay, in order to do your business. Though it is a very commercial at the outlook, if you get into it, how government organizations do public relation, and then there are public relation offices, like, you know, in order to deliver the information of government, of different departments. Okay, so for example, you have Information and Broadcasting Ministry. Okay, it delivers whatever the policies, whatever the developmental issues that comes up, policies comes up with, the government comes up with. The Information Ministry Department communicates that to the public. Okay, so they usually do this, what actually government does, what is government doing in order to tackle. So now they are doing a very good job of, communicating what are the measures that is being taken by government to tackle this problem of COVID-19. So this relationship is very, very important that you have to basically understand why relationship is important. Okay, so this is something beyond your syllabus that you have to think. So syllabus would give you just points, but you have to, in order to answer your assertion and then reason, you have to think beyond your syllabus. Okay, so there are a lot of books with respect to your PR and then corporate communications. So today I would be just going through, like, you know, what are the points in each and every things, every subtopics that you have to look into. Then you have ethics of public relation. This is something very, very important. So you may not get very direct questions with regard to your ethics. So like how we discussed in the last class, and even all the other teachers would have discussed, like how it is, sometimes you won't get the direct questions. Sometimes you do get direct questions. Sometimes you don't get direct questions. Usually assertion won't be very direct. It is statements. So what I would suggest you is, so know in and out of PR and then corporate communication, what exactly PR does, why is it important? Okay, and what are the activities done by PR? And then what are the different PR agencies that we have? Okay, so agencies also plays a very important role. So then you have to keep an eye on house journals. Okay, so usually when I was just randomly picking up, there was a question about house journal. So on, so you have to just match it. So they have given house, what is a journal, name of the journal, and then the company. So you have to match it. So house journals becomes a very important thing. It is one of the tools or a technique that has been used in order to, advertise about your company. Okay. And to know what is happening in your company too. It is also a kind of documentation where it gives a track of what is happening in the organization. So house journals play a very important role. So you have to keep an eye on house journals, and then organization where, like, what is in-house PR, okay, and what is the PR that is done outside the organization. That's very, very important. I think most of you have already know, like, you know, PR as a subject, because it is there in your UG also, right? So in-house and then with other, okay, of house, what happens, what actually goes in order to keep up a very good will in the minds of the people. Okay, it is not only consumers that you have to keep in your mind. So what I'm trying to say is, it is not just your syllabus. You should understand PR, like, you know, as a whole, how it actually works. Okay, and what are the limitations that it has? Because this is how it has been asked, like, you know, when you look into the question papers. So even limitations becomes a very important element to know. So what I would suggest is a very important thing is house journal, okay, and then agencies, and then names, okay, very importantly. The father of PR is very important because they have asked questions about father of PR and as such. And then you have international public relations communication audit. So this is also very important. So international public relations, how, what are the organization which works in order to keep our international relations in good terms? Okay, that you have to look into. So to start with, okay, The very first question, okay, it is about corporate public relations deals with, okay. So this is the first question which I randomly just picked it up. So as I said earlier, it is a very direct question. So corporate public PR, corporate PR, okay, deals with what? Does it deal with the whole organization, goods and services, profit and payments, publicity and propaganda? And when you look into the options, it is like, you know, you feel all the answers are correct, right? Don't you feel that? I want the session to be very interactive. Otherwise, it becomes difficult for me to, you know, handle. So can anyone please answer me? Like, hello? I hope network with all others are fine. Hello? Karmal ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, is it?
Okay. They are giving the answers in chat box.
Oh,
so you can unmute yourself and you can answer, okay?
Yeah, please unmute, yeah. Don't use chat box. So that interaction is very important. Chat box is when we have issues, we can have it, we can answer it in. Yeah. D. Publicity and propaganda. Publicity and propaganda. Okay. Doesn't it deal with the whole organization? Goods and services, because I said, like, you know, PR talks about goods and services that is being provided by the company. Unless you know what the company is providing, yeah, how do you connect yourself with the organization? Now, unless I know, kindly if you're not answering, kindly mute, because I'm getting some kind of noise. Yeah. Hello, can someone interpret it, please? Because it's a very easy question. Internet is unstable. Hello, Karmal ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the problem here? Yeah? Is there any problem with the student?
No, ma'am, you are audible. And about the students, I don't know. If you have any issues, please.
I'll chat. I'll put it in the chat. Yeah. Box. Yeah. Sorry to disturb you.
Yeah. It's fine. Everyone can unmute, okay?
Hello? Mr. Selva, can you talk? Hello? Unmuting is locked. Ajit sir, can you please allow them to unmute themselves?
No, Ajit, all participants are unmuted. You can mute yourself. Like, you can unmute yourself.
Yeah, but hello? Unmute is locked. Yeah, hello?
Yes, right now it's audible.
Okay. Who is
I think, Selva.
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon. Yes. Selva. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, ma'am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I think the answer, the A option is the answer, right answer.
A option is right. Okay, yeah. Why not D?
Because it speaks about publicity and propaganda. But corporate public relation deals with, because the, you need to communicate within the organization. That is what I feel. Corporate public, because it is something which is related within the organization.
Okay.
Because in general, maybe PR may be related to publicity and propaganda. That is what I feel. Because it speaks, corporate public relation is something related within the organization for the employees. That is how I interpret. I don't know whether right or wrong.
Okay. Even I don't
because
know.
Because other options, I don't know. Goods and services, profit and payments. No, but
why do you think goods and why do you think goods and services is one of the options? See, that is why I told you yesterday, even your option should be interpreted. Unless you understand your option, you cannot give the right answer. Right. And most of the times in UGC NET, what happens, any competitive exams for that matter, they confuse you by giving very related
options.
So, okay, that is one of the interpretation. Others? Others? Other than Mr. Selva? Mr. Selva, what are you doing?
Yes, I'm into teaching. Teaching. Teaching.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Where do you teach, sir?
In Madras Christian College, Chennai.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Other than Selva, sir, any other interpretations, please? Okay. Kindly, please unmute yourselves and then be part of the session. Otherwise, it becomes difficult. Okay. Yes. So now we will look into corporate public relations deals with publicity and then propaganda, the whole organization. So the first interpretation is as such, like corporate is within the organization. So that is why it is the whole organization, not publicity and propaganda. It doesn't matter. So each one of you can have your own interpretations, but I would be really happy if you can give the right answer at the end. Okay. Because I don't want to reveal the answer. So I want you to interpret and then understand what it is and then analyze and tell me why it is that particular answer. Okay. I hope you're fine with it. So I'll move to the next question. So next question here is where, you have to think as many times as possible, because this is very tricky. Usually assertion and then reasoning is very tricky. So second question is, the PR exercises seldom save in company in crisis, seldom save a company in crisis, and public relations exercises are dubious in nature. So here there are two things. Okay. So the PR exercises seldom save in a crisis, company in a crisis. Public relation exercises are dubious in nature. Can someone please interpret it? Please, you have to take part. Otherwise, it becomes difficult for you. Hello? Okay, but the PR person must have knowledge about the other three, public propaganda. Okay. Yes. Tell me if the second option is. Hello. I have put a question in the chat box because you people are active in the chat box than interacting with me. Do you feel that PR is very uncertain in nature? Don't you think PR has its own, PR is a very well-planned and organized sector, right? So it is actually false. Okay, so this first one is correct. Wherein PR exercises and very often, that seldom is very often, it exercises in when there is a crisis in the company, right? So public relation exercises are dubious in nature, means it is not certain, okay? But it is wrong. It is very certain in its nature. So A is true and R is false, okay? In order to know whether it is, which one is the right answer, don't you think it is very important to know PR, functions of PR it is, and then the nature of PR. Okay. If you know exactly what is the nature of PR, then you will be able to understand whether this given statement is right or wrong. Okay. So, and then you have to find a relationship between A and then R, because R is an explanation that is being given to the assertion, right? So it says seldom it saves the company in crisis. That is true, but public relation exercises are dubious in nature is wrong. Okay. So what I'm trying to say from this is it is very important for you to have a clear knowledge about nature of PR. So that is why in your syllabus, nature of PR is also there, scope of PR is also there. That is a basic understanding that you have to have about the subject, any topic for that matter. So I hope the second one is also you have understood how usually they ask the questions. So knowing the nature is very important, and then where exactly the scope of PR is also very, very important. So the first question deals with the scope and the second reason deals with the nature. Okay. So scope is where exactly PR is, scope is goes into the crisis also. Okay. It doesn't limit itself to the organization. Okay. It doesn't just, limits itself to advertising the goods and services that is provided by the company. Okay. It is not only the relationship. Okay. It is something beyond that. That is, it also acts very, it should very actively, participate in cracking the crisis that arises in the industries very often. Now, this COVID is also a crisis. Okay, it is a very big crisis. It is an international crisis. It is not just one geographical area that we are talking about. So how government organization is trying to tackle this particular crisis that has been arisen. Okay, this is something which was not prepared. So there are most of the times your crises are not, it cannot be planned. Okay, there are some crises which you can plan because when you know how your business is happening. Okay, so based on that, whether your business is in a good shape or not, you can forecast your financial status of the company. But there are some crises which is beyond your it's not in your hands, okay, beyond your control. So that is where you have to understand the scope of PR. So please make points scope means what are the different areas where PR comes into picture. Is it only this? So try to refer different books, different authors, and then make sure that you know the maximum scope of PR. And I hope you all know what scope is all about. So next is PR relations exercises are dubious in nature. And they have said it is it is not certain in nature, but it is very wrong. Okay. So they have a very well organized sector is PR. Okay. So they have ethics also. They have a body which looks into your activity. Okay. And it is not only corporate. It is not only private. Even NGOs, the civil society also do PR. So that is what you have to keep in your mind. So okay, I'm asking this question. Am I audible? Am I audible? Carmel, ma'am?
Ma'am, now we are audible. Your voice was breaking. Now it's okay.
Okay,
it's
okay. Yeah. My internet is very unstable. I'm sorry.
Now it's audible.
Okay. Yeah. Anushree, Ms. Anushree? Anushree, ma'am, can you please?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Anushree, ma'am. Do you know who is Ivy Led Better Lee is?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. Praveen, sir? Praveen, sir? Can you please unmute yourself and speak? Rebecca, ma'am? Can you please unmute yourself?
Yes, ma'am. I don't know.
Yes. You don't know. Okay. Selva, sir, any idea? Selva, sir? Okay. So I'll just proceed. So Ivy Led Better is the father of modern PR, that is public relation. Again, what I'm trying to say is it is important to know the fathers, okay? The fathers of the subject that you're trying to learn. Okay, very, very important. So you have father of journalism, you have father of PR, you have father of mathematics, father of, lot of things. Any subject you take for that matter. So Ivy Led Better Lee is a legend in PR, started his career as, who will know, what was his career? What he started his career? We wouldn't have thought of such questions, because most of the times we do not, we just stop ourselves, we limit ourselves to who is the father of PR. Okay, then we will not go beyond that. We would just know about him and which country he belongs to. Okay, that's it. Not more than that. So, but here, this question should make you understand. You should know through this question that even this kind of questions will be asked. Whether he started as a businessman, press agent, lobbyist, reporter, that you have to find out. Okay. So maybe you might connect it. He was a reporter. Maybe because of that, there is a question. There is such question. Okay, because reporter and journalism goes hand in hand. Reporter is journalism, right? So, or it might confuse you when you see lobbyist and then press agent, okay, and businessman. So usually business, when we think of PR, we immediately we connect ourselves with a businessman, okay? So there are possibilities. So that's the reason you have such options. Very confusing. And nobody will make an attempt to know what was his first career. How did he start his career? Okay. So this is also very important. So what I'm trying to say with this question is, these kind of questions are also being asked in your UGC NET. So what I'm trying to say, whatever you read, you make a point, you please write it down somewhere. So that it will be there in your mind. Okay. So at least you will have a clue. You won't be clueless. You will have a clue. Okay. At least you can, shortlist press agent. And then you have read somewhere. Okay. You have written it down, but you're not trying to recall the that particular profession. Okay, at least you can have two options with you. Okay, so that is what I'm trying to say. So it is very important to keep these points also in your mind. Don't limit yourselves to father of PR or father of journalism. Okay, so just go beyond that. Which country he belongs to, what was his idea or understanding of PR is also very important, because last class we just looked into the content where what is development for this particular author. Okay, according to so and so, what is development? Okay, so such questions were there. So to carry forward, so you just have to look into subject in these you know, area also, and then understand it better. Okay, yes. Okay, so next is hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You're able to follow me, no? No problem. Okay, yes. So next is fourth one. In public information model of PR, importance is given to what? Okay, so in public information model of PR, importance is given to, the answer is truth. Okay, or fair deal, reception, and impact. Okay. What is the importance that has been given? This is a very basic question that you have. That Anushri, yes, you will have to tell me the answer for the previous question. Okay, yes, we will be in touch with. So we will discuss more about it. Then we will see. Okay, the answer. Why I'm giving you some answers, like, you know, because some questions I want to explain it with the answers. Some questions I want to explain it with the questions itself. Okay. That is a pattern. That is a change pattern. I am just following. I'm following it. Okay. Yes. So in public information model of PR, importance is given to truth. Okay. But now again, it is very contradictory. In the sense, when you say business, usually, so if you're talking about corporate communication, you have, what is it? Okay, so here it is truth. It is very, 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 like, you know, what is it? Very confusing. Okay, impact, reception, truth, fair deal. If I ask you, okay, if question is asked to you, like, you know, which one would you shortlist and why? Charlotte, Miss Charlotte.
Hello.
Yes, Charlotte. Can you please, like, you know, I'm just randomly picking people.
No problem. According to what I had read, public information model of PR usually follows the dissemination of information in one way. It's a one-way approach. So that is why, since the information is only one way, they make it sure that whatever information is being disseminated or contributed is truthful and accurate information.
Very good.
It cannot be manipulated. And also that the information that they share has to be objective in nature. Hello.
Ah, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
is it Ms. Charlotte?
Charlotte, yeah.
Yes, I listened to your answer, I mean interpretation. That's actually correct. But if you do not know that, okay, like say for example, I'm not sure with that. Okay, I'm a person, I don't have much idea about PR. Okay, so I might think like, you know, it's a fair deal. It's a deal between like, you know, people and then organization. Okay, when it is advertisement, when it is a corporate communication, most of the times what happens, it is commercialized, right? They do not think about the, what is it? They just mostly think about the business part of it, but not what exactly, but not the truth. Okay. If I think in that way, then I might click on fair deal. Okay. Truth. Okay, but again, it is like, you know, I don't know. It can be, it is a debatable issue. You can debate it, you know, out of your framework of your syllabus. Okay. So that is one thing. And your next question is assertion again. So here they have said for many corporate communication is a necessary evil in an era of globalization, and PR as a tool of advertising will have to make exaggerated claims and distort facts for a favorable image creation. Charlotte, are you listening to me? Hello?
Hello.
Okay. Yes, now ma'am. You can hear. Okay. Yes, Charlotte, can you please read the second one, second reason?
Yeah, public relations as a tool of advertising will have to make exaggerated claims and distort facts for a favorable image creation.
Okay. Isn't it a very plain understanding of PR?
Yeah, it could be, but...
It could be, yeah. It could be. There is a possibility, right?
Yes, yes.
Why there is a possibility?
Because as you said, ma'am, you know, many use it for commercialization.
Commercialization.
See, and now, also mainly because it's a tool of advertising.
Yes, that's what I was coming to that point. So it clearly says that PR, public relation as a tool of advertising. Okay. Yeah. So if it is a tool of advertising, how can it be truth? Right. So... on that point, you have to understand PR. Okay. I don't know. Charlotte, did I make sense?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So now at this level, you have to understand PR. So this is how you should prepare for your exams. Okay. Not just like, you know, most of us, we just do it like, you know, we just take things from here and there, read this, read that. But we are not applying any logic in preparing for our exams, right? So you should analyze each and every question. And that is when you understand, okay, what kind of questions can be expected. So here, these are the confusing terminologies that they have used. Anybody for that matter, even if you have read PR, even if you're working as PR, the statement is like, you know, a minute or so, like, you know, you'll become like, you know, you just think, you just, you know, don't react immediately, right? So that is why they want to confuse you by using such terminologies. If I simply say like, you know, public relations done by, you know, civil societies for that matter, then you might think, okay, it is for truth. And government, again, yeah, come on. Like, you just analyze the PR things of, PR contents of PR communication that is done by a government organization. You think that is all truth? Right. So it's a debatable issue, but as a subject, when you get into it, your scope, nature, and these kind of things, the contradictory things, you have to be very clear. The answer that you gave, why it is truth, okay, that's a very good observation. That is how you should deal with your subject. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Charlotte. Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you so much. Okay. So now the answer is like, you know, A is true, but R is false. Okay. It is not a favorable image creation. Okay. That again, you should read, and then interpret it in a way that, okay, the statement is false. Okay. Yes. Okay. Yes. Now, as I mentioned it in the beginning, like, you know, match the list one with the list two. Okay. These are the house journals of different companies. Okay. Now, how do you analyze this? Now, you should analyze it in a way that what are the top, like, you know, what are the companies that they have asked? Bank of India, Hindustan Lever, Air India, and Mahanagar Telephone. Are they all international companies? Are they all national companies or international companies? Hello? Carmel, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're okay, audible. Okay. They are giving the answers in the chat box.
I'm checking chat box. I didn't get anything. Okay, now, yeah. Okay, yes, they're all Indian, right? Unable to mute. Okay, okay, government companies. Okay, very good. Okay, national Indian government companies. Okay, now I can't say that, you know, in the next exam, next year exam or next term exam, they would ask about Indian companies only. Okay. What I'm trying to tell you is you interpret it in a way that whether it is Indian companies, international companies, why have they given, why out of all, why did they choose these companies? Is there any rationale behind choosing this particular options? Okay. So usually when it is a corporate communication, you always have journals which gives the ratings. Okay, top 10, top 20. Okay, so in SAARC Nations, this is the top.
Mamta, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Okay. Yes. Yes. So house journals. So here you have a house journal and then it is just like your other subjects. They give you the models and then the name of the person who is given the model. Okay. And then who, what is that? Other than that, it's like, you know, they give you the movies, the top movies. Okay. Of, very prominent director's name. Okay. So then they would ask you to match. So usually when it comes to what I have seen, what I have observed, whenever they ask match the following, this most of the times it is house journal and then the company. Okay. So please keep an eye and make points, whatever I'm trying to whatever is important, whatever I'm highlighting, please make a note of it. Okay, so now you have to look into the house journal and then the companies. Okay, you just take a sheet of paper and then you just jot it down. Okay, what are the different companies and then the house name of the house journals. The next one is your PR Society of India observes National PR Day on. Okay, this is another important simple thing, but you have to remember it. Okay, so PR Society of India observes National PR Day on. Okay, what day is today? What is special today?
Today is Doctor's Day.
Very good. Today is Doctor's Day, right? So like that, you should remember the major events, related to journalism. Okay. I hope you know about this. So PR, what can, with regard to your dates, what could be the, what would they ask? You just have to list out what are the different important dates of PR. So National PR Day, you have to, and then just look at the option. It is so, so very confusing, right? April 21, April 20, 21, and then 20. Okay. So I'm just giving you an idea, this is how they ask questions. So you have to be clear, and please again, make a note of it, and then try to have important dates with regard to your journalism and each subject, development, communication, PR. Okay. And today is another day, very important day. What is it? Journalism students. Okay, tell me at the end of the session. Now you have very important, very simple, but very confusing. Okay. The main objectives of PR. What are the main objectives? Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
Yeah, yes. The main objectives of PR. Okay. Yesterday, the last class also I said you have to keep a very, you should observe the objectives very carefully. Okay. So objectives of PR, objectives of corporate communication, objective of development communication, national policy. Okay. So objectives play a very important role, and usually you will have one or the two questions with regard to objectives. So keep an eye on objectives and then make a note of it. Okay. Each and every objectives, you please write it down, and then you derive a question. You should confuse yourself and then just try out with different options where you can, you know your objectives very well. So no options should make you, should confuse you. Okay. So to that level, you should know the objectives. Okay. So increase the sale of manufactured goods, enhance the image of organization in public domain, make internal policies public, keep the channels of grape wine open. Okay. So what is it? Okay. So you will be giving answers for this at the end of the session. Okay. So again, this I'm trying to extract it from your side so that you will know, how when you're searching for the answer, you will come up with a lot of information, and then you will know how they have extracted the question. Okay. Please guys, you just look into this thing. Okay. So according to the British Institute of PR, the fourth stage in any PR campaign is off. Okay, what is the fourth stage? So in PR campaign, what happens? Last class we were talking about campaigns, right? So there were a lot of campaigns in order to bring in development in communities and, lot of different communities, different areas, different spheres and all of that. But now here, a PR has campaigns, okay? So you have advertisement campaigns, okay? The PR campaigns, all of that. So, but PR campaign has stages are involved in it. So you have a particular stage in which your campaign goes, okay? And British
ma'am.
British Institute of PR is very important. So please underline that British Institute of PR. So what I'm trying to say through this particular question, you have to know the important bodies of PR of any subject for that matter. Okay. So now yesterday we discussed on global communication, right? And then national policy, national communication policy. These are the terms, these are the bodies which are very, very important. Okay. Policy with regard to policies. But here, why British Institute of PR becomes so important? Okay. So we have a lot of things which has been derived, which we have in our Indian country or any third world countries. Most of them are derived from different countries. Okay. So you have to know the bodies that is involved in your subject. Okay. So please underline British Institute of PR and then make points like, you know, whatever with regard to PR, whatever British Institute has, talks on, you just please keep, make a note of it. Okay. So that's very, very important. And then you have the International PR Review is the publication of, okay, so there are different journals, like you have IPRA, EAPRA, and CRP and FAPRO. Okay, all these are the journals of PR. Okay, so now the International PR Review is a publication of, so these people publish. Okay, so you have to also keep an eye on the publications. Okay, so now this is the International PR Review is a publication of IPRA. Okay, it is one of the very reputed journals. So you have to keep an eye on the journals also. Okay, I hope you are trying to get an idea about, like, you know, how questions are asked. Okay, which corner, which, like, you know, on what criteria they're trying to, you know, extract information. I mean, okay, now 10th was 1 minute. Okay, so yeah. So then the 11th one is about PR is again now assertion and then reasoning. You have PR is more an attitude than a technique. Okay, as it is an internal as it is an external evidence of managing international affairs of an institution in a way that makes it maintain the status quo. Okay, so now you have to read all the options and then read the assertion and then reasoning and then give me the answer. Okay, I will share these PPTs if you want, so you can just give me the answers later also. Okay. So again, here it is like, you know, what is it? It deals with, can anyone tell me, like, the previous assertion and reason dealt with scope and then the nature. Now, can you just analyze your question? Like, PR is more an attitude than a technique. Can anyone do it for me? Praveen sir, you fine with your connection? I mean, internet connection. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
You're following me?
Yes, I'm following you, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Okay. Can you just interpret this question for me, please? Because there is no point, like, you know, just discussing, like, you should be able to understand what I'm trying to,
yes, know,
communicate. Yeah,
so it is about the attitude or a technique. So PR is like basically a technique which also needs an attitude, because a person without an attitude cannot handle PR situation properly.
Very nice. Yeah.
So I think A is true.
Mm-hmm.
It is an external evidence of managing international affairs of an institution in a way that makes it maintain the status quo. So I think the attitude will have to maintain a status quo of the organization. So I think both A and R are true.
Okay, very good. What do you do, sir? Do you?
I'm a teacher.
Oh, okay. Okay. So that's a good interpretation. Okay.
Thank you.
So yeah, thank you, sir. Okay. So this is how. Okay. So attitude and then technique. So again, you're analyzing the aspect of an attitude and you're analyzing the aspect of the technique also. Okay. So this is how you have to interpret it. So so please, like, you know, whenever you look into, whenever you read something, please make a note of it. Okay. So assertion and reason is quite tricky and it is sometimes difficult too. Okay. So make sure that you just look into all the, I mean, you know, assertions and then reasons and then analyze it and then you answer it. And then when you read some other content, you should be able to, again, like, you know, derive assertion and then reason on your own. Okay. So that is when you can understand questions better. Okay. The last one is, I have just, I have 12 questions today. The systems theory of public relation is described as a set of united. What is it? Whether it is pressure groups, subsystems, employee system, and then production system. So here it is talking about the theory. Okay. The system theory of public relation. So you have to read the system theory also. Okay. That is when you will be able to understand or answer the question. That is the last question. So as a whole, like, you know, if I have to put it into a nutshell, so you have to read your scope, nature of PR, and then what is that, important persons, like, you know, your father of PR, okay, that you have to look into. And then it is not only that, like, whatever it is related to your journalism and then PR, you have to link it and then you have to underline the points there. And then you have to look into the ethics and then the objectives, okay, objectives of PR and then corporate communication, any topic for that matter, you have to be very clear with the objectives. And then the house journal, okay, it's very important is house journal and then the companies. Okay, that you have to look into. And then sometimes you know the house journal, but you do not know which company's house journal it is. So you make sure that you list it out and then keep it, like, you know, you have the information. So you can just glance before you go to your exam. So objective and this body, this house journal, and then the theory, and then the very important bodies, like, you know, the previous question, okay, that is about British Institute of PR, that you have to keep an eye on, and then the publications you have to keep an eye on, and then system theory, okay, anything which is related to this. And again, I'm repeating, it is not only this, okay, but you stick to the syllabus that has been mentioned in the UGC UGC website. So next I will get into the definition. Okay, so now it starts with the definitions. So there are a lot of definitions which defines PR. Okay, there are a lot of authors also define PR. So we will just look into the different definitions and then we can just derive questions out of it. So public relations means to achieve mutual adjustment between institution. I'm not able to read. Oops. Hello. Okay. So public relations means to achieve mutual adjustment between institutions and not able to read. Okay, I'll read the next one. That is, PR is an essential element in the communication system that enables individuals to be informed on many aspects of subjects that affect their lives. Okay, can someone derive a question for this? Is it possible? You need not give an option. Maybe it is difficult at this point of time. Yes, Praveen sir said yes. Yeah, it would be really great if you can derive a question for based on the definition of PR. Any one definition is fine. And even I'm not looking out for options.
Ma'am?
Yes, yes.
We could. The question could be like this. Mm-hmm. The essential mm-hmm. element mm-hmm. of communication in PR is to...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. To be informed on many aspects of subjects that affect their lives. Okay. Yes,
that would be an option to inform...
Okay, okay, okay. With that, you can give some other options also. Okay, okay. Anyone else?
I think this is related to the first question which you asked about the corporate PR.
Selva sir, yes,
yeah, yeah, corporate PR. So I think PR is an essential element in the communication system that enables individuals to be informed many aspects. So it covers about the products, goods and services, about the company, everything, the whole organization.
Yes.
That is what I interpret.
Wow. Okay.
Your first question. Yeah. Because that all affect their lives.
very keen observation. That's really great. Yeah. Yes. Selva sir, then I think you should be able to crack net, no?
I just missed with few points last time.
Oh, okay.
Just
okay.
0.30.
Oh, okay. Better luck next time, sir.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
I wish you clear JRF also. Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. So this can be you can derive questions on, or you can with respect to the first definition that is given, PR means to achieve mutual adjustment between institution and groups. Okay. That this also you can underline, whether it is institution and group. Okay. As I said earlier, PR, it is not just the institution alone. It is also outside your organization. Okay. So establishing smoother relationship that benefit the public. Okay, so again, it is whether through benefiting public, it is in a way benefiting your organization also, right? That is why it is a mutual adjustment. Am I clear? So you have to understand it in that way. Okay. Okay. So next one is, I'm sorry, this blank. Okay. There is another definition that is being given. PR, it means for the public to have its desires and interests felt by the institution in our society. It interprets and speaks for the public to otherwise unresponsive organizations, as well as speaking for those organizations to the public. Again, it is combination of what we already discussed. Okay. Next, you have elements of public affairs. This is a very important thing. I just picked up randomly just picked up from a book, so that it will help you to understand the public affairs development includes these elements. Okay, that is communication. So communication is very important. It is one of the elements of your public affair. So publicity and then media relations. So communication happens by publicizing your goods and service or your organization service, and media relations through which you are communicating about your organization. Okay, it is not only organization, the service, or you know, how the public would be benefiting. Okay, so it is about publicity and then media relations, and then government relation is very, very important. That is your federal, state, and then local. So most of the times what happens, your relationships with the local, and most of the times we target like, you know, there are target groups for each and every service providers. Okay, so they who are their customers, like, you know, whom do they cater to, all of that. But relationship goes beyond that. Okay, whether you're catering to a particular community or not, so the goodwill that is going to create, okay, about your company, okay, it is possible only when you reach out out of your box, okay, not only your targeted group, but other than the targeted group. So that is why your government relationship with your federal, state, local is very, very important. So you might you might get questioned about elements of public affairs also. So I have just listed it out. And then you have political actions, okay, grassroots activities, political action committees. So if you look into the campaigns of, say, for example, can you just find out, like, you know, you have public relation campaign and then advertising campaign. Can you just tell me what is the difference? Is there any difference? If there is difference, what difference do you find? Yes, please, I want an answer for this. Let's not waste our time.
Yeah. Advertising is only for informing the people.
Okay.
PR is both to inform and also to help the better working of the organization.
Okay. Okay. So advertising campaign is one of the tools or the techniques that is used by a used by PR organization. Should I take it that way? Hello? I think it was Praveen, sir.
Yes, it was me.
Okay. Yes, Praveen, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So you said, so what I'm trying to ask, so advertisement campaigns are one of the tools or the techniques that is used by PR organizations?
They can use it as a tool.
It can be a tool.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So it can be a tool. Okay. It can, I mean, sometimes it is not a tool. I mean, it can be a tool, but it reaches a very large mass. Okay. So that is why if you look into any advertisement campaigns, if you look into, so they're all very, can you name any one, just one campaign, advertisement campaign? Anyone? So through that, I'll just give you, like, advertising campaign.
Daag Acche Hai.
Daag Acche Hai.
Surfex, okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I think in advertising campaign, they can control the content which is actually going out. But in PR, once they let out the information, it is not in their control. It completely depends on the public then later.
Okay. So again, we go back to the truth.
Yeah.
Truth, na? Okay.
Yes, yes.
So whether it is truth or not truth. So again, it is a commercial, the same, right? So I think we can have a debate. I mean, we can discuss on this, like, you know, in a different platform or something. Now, I'm just giving you, like, you know, political action, like, you know, to reaching out to the public. Okay, what are the elements, the public affairs, I mean, elements that you can use to reach out? So we will keep it aside, like, you know, whether the PR campaigns and then the advertisement campaign. So advertisement campaign, definitely it is a tool that can be used. Okay. So there are a limit, any tools and techniques that you're using, it has its own limitations. But as Charlotte said, like, you know, whatever the information that is coming from the organization, basically it is going to be truth. Okay. So yes, we will discuss it some other time. Okay. So now you have a corporate responsibility, that is communication, community relations, and then social responsibility program. So PR organization, continuously they have this such, activities like social responsibility program and community relations. So what I'm trying to say through this is, like, you have some elements, no? So you just look into how PR is working in each and every element. Okay? How are they publicizing things? How are they using media relations? Okay, what are the tools and techniques that they are using? Okay, if you could make that would be easier for you to, like, you know, answer a lot of questions actually. Okay, so this is one elements of public affairs, and next is, terminologies. Okay, so why terminologies are important? If you look into video production, if you look into camera, okay, anything related to electronic media, you have terminologies. Okay, you have terminologies in all the subjects for that matter. But why terminologies becomes important is, like, you know, like, that is where we get confused with terminologies. So once we are clear with the terminologies, when we are defining our PR, or when we are understanding PR as a subject, you won't go wrong. That is what I believe. So terminologies are important, and based on terminologies also you will be asked questions. Okay, so industry. Now propaganda, most of the times, like, you know, propaganda is something which is been asked, and it is sometimes confusing also. Propaganda is being used in different ways. So, but here in PR, what is propaganda? Okay, what is publicity? So publicity, again, like, you know, publicity in PR, okay, what is it? So it is a dissemination of purposefully planned and executed messages. So as we discussed earlier, it is not unplanned. So any communication that happens through the PR organization or PR, of a company or an industry, or was executed message through a selected media. So any PR for that matter, you know how it goes. Okay, the planning goes, and there is a PR person who looks into the this PR publicity things of the organization. So so here you have to underline that planned and executed messages. Okay, publicity means just for publicity. In political sphere, publicity is different. Okay, so PR publicity is different. I hope you are able to understand why terminologies are important. Okay, so if, hello.
Hello.
Ah, yes. Able yes, to hear me? Okay. So publicity, if it is asked in terms of PR, then it is very planned and it is executed for a particular purpose. Okay. So PR of a company will know, okay, what to be communicated to the mass. Okay. Whether you're communicating it to the community, or whether you're communicating through media, or whether you're communicating to your lobbying. Okay, you're talking to the government, whether it is local, federal, state, or whatever, okay, whatever level it is. So you have to understand publicity in PR. That is very, very important. So most of the times what happens, publicity means we just generalize the term. Okay, so that is why terminologies that is used in PR are different. Okay, so if there is a question related to publicity, you should look into in what context it has been asked. Okay, whether it is a political context, whether it is a social context, or whether it is a PR context. Okay, so that is very important. So you have to underline. So please go through the terminologies that has been used in PR, because most of the times when I take class, like, you know, this corporate communication, public relations, are most of the times it is being confused. So students think that whether it is, whether it is truth or not truth. These are the kind of debates that we usually have. But if we know what is actually it is, what is nature, what is the scope and terminologies that they use, and in what context they use the terminologies, then you will not have issues. So the next is you have some objectives, okay, to achieve this. I'm sorry, there is a mistake. Not objects, objectives, okay. So these are all the objectives, if you could read, okay, properly practiced at the corporate level, should be an integral part of the management team, serving alongside such other staff functions as, finance, personal, legal, and then long range planning, okay, and then to provide guidance and counsel on the corporation's basic decision process. So a lot of things, these are the objectives. A company means it is not going to just think of, or it is, that function is not just to give publicity, okay. There are other things, like, you know, it has to look into the finance, the personal, and the legal issues that is related to, and planning, the range of planning, everything goes in, okay. Guidance, and then the counsel on the corporation's basic decisions process, okay. At the same time, it must be geared to provide professional communications planning and services to both the corporations as well as the various operating units on the broad range of subjects, from management communication to financial discourse, disclosure to marketing publicity. So this is the basic objective of a public relation of any company, for that matter. So just, you have to be very thorough. Okay. Then no options can confuse you. Okay. So to achieve this options, to achieve this, sorry, objectives, so PR staff must be prepared to function in four basic service areas. Okay. So these are the objectives of a PR, okay, of PR. The public relations. So these mentioned functions are something, basic service area that they should look into. One is advice, one is communication service, public issues research and analysis, public relations and action program. Very, very, very important. This is an outline in which any PR organization works, you know, advises or takes advices, and communication services. Or communication service is something very, very, it is the, you know, hardcore function of your PR. Okay. So communication services you have to think of, and public issues research and analysis. See, if you don't analyze the public issues and then the research, okay, with regard to your own company, okay, you cannot analyze, you cannot function, you cannot plan your future, okay. So that is where you have to look into, let me not get into the explanation. So you have to look into the functions, what are the different functions, and how is it, what are the tools that used in order to take up these functions. So that you have to keep in your mind. And the next is functions of PR department. So there are various functions. Okay, there are many functions, but these are the important questions, functions of the PR department. So one is public relations policy. So you can expect any questions from public relations policies, and then corporate statements, corporate publicity, product publicity. Okay, in publicity itself, there are a lot of different types, okay, that you have to look into. And government relations, okay, your relations with government, and what are the tools and techniques that is used in order to keep up good relationship with the government, and why it is important that you should look into. And then community relations is also very, very important. I told you, it is not your only target group, it is also beyond that, okay. So then you have institutional promotion, corporate donations, employee publication, and guest relations. So employee publication is also important, and we have already discussed, like, you know, related to that we have questions. And then you have corporate donations. Again, it is what is it? Corporate donation comes under your CRS, corporate social CSR, okay, for corporate social responsibility. So what companies, like, you know, how do they, what is that? On what area they invest their money? Like, you know, what are the different corporate social services that is being taken up by major companies that you have to look into? So these are the functions of PR. So next, I 1 minute. Yeah, this is end of my PPT. But now I will look into, I mean, I'll just tell you, like, what are the other things that you have to keep in your mind when you're preparing for your exams. Okay. Okay. Techniques of communication you should look into. The techniques of communication, that is preparations for communicating, okay, planning and publicity program, news and publicity, planning publicity, arranging for approvals, organizing the files, special events, product publicity, media publicity, controlling rumors, okay. Controlling rumor is also very, very important, okay. You can, you might be asked question about, you know, the rumor that, the rumors spread, you know, about a particular organization. Okay, so Maggie, we had that was a very big crisis, right? So Maggie, what was the rumor? What was the rumor?
That it had an extra, what is that? Some ingredient. Some artificial ingredient.
Okay.
Added MSG.
Okay.
So it was mentioned that no added MSG was given, but it had MSG, that was the problem.
How did they deal with it, sir? It's a very big crisis because Maggie is not a, like, you know, it's a very old product, right? So it was a very big crisis.
I think they handle the situations by, like, giving it for samples. Mm. I mean, samples tested in different testing agencies, labs, and then giving away the results that it is safe and other things. That is how they manage, I think.
And build it, yeah. Okay. And now, if you look into the, you know, market for Maggie, it is. As usual.
Yeah, it's good, actually.
Yeah, it's good.
They're back in business.
Yes, they're back. So how did they manage this crisis? So you should look into the crisis management. What are the criteria were, you know, used or taken? I mean, criteria used in order to, you know, tackle this particular crisis. So that you have to look into. So there are a lot of managemental crises, and government also, like, you know, during crisis, how did they, what are the techniques that that particular organization used, and then, you know, how communication played a very important role that you have to keep in your mind. This is, like, you know, when I looked into question papers, there are no questions, like, you know, related to crisis and all that, but I'm just giving you, like, you know, what are the points that you can just look into so that you will be able to answer. Okay, yes. So then you have relations with publicity media. Okay, pattern of working with media. That is very important. So in this, I'm just sticking to the syllabus that is there. Okay, techniques of communication. Okay, so you have to look into the patterns. Okay, there are different patterns. You can't follow the same pattern that you follow it for newspaper, and that you follow it for your television and other media, social media for that matter. So you have to look into the patterns, okay? So you might be able to derive some questions out of it. And usually this crisis management questions are asked, like, you know, in your assertion and then reasoning, okay? So, but I have not come across, like, you know, basically it is about the questions which I discussed with you. It is like that, objectives, definitions, scope, nature, like that. So give more importance to that part, okay? And then this you just glance it, okay? and what is it? Exclusive story, news conference, briefings, and then introduction. Okay, and then you have guidelines for sensitive interviews. Okay, that you have to look into, and then publicity in TV and radio you have to look into. Okay, so these are just like, you know, topics that I'm discussing it with you. Okay, and then you have to also keep in mind, I mean, you have to also prepare for your international PR relations. Okay, so the major developments that has happened in international PR relations, you have to look into. That is the last part of your unit. Okay, so then you have public relation and crisis management. One more thing, I just noted it down. Tools and techniques. Okay, that's what you have to keep in your mind. The most common tools or techniques for delivering the organization's communication, like, you know, what are other things, like, you know, annual report. Okay, so they might ask you, like, what is that? It is just like, you know, I'm guessing it, like, you know, I'm just trying to derive. They might ask you, like, what are the tools and used in order to, you know, delivering the organization information. Okay, annual reports are one of the very best source, tools that can be used. And then news release and news announcements are very, very important. Okay, they might ask you, like, you know, which are, Hello? Okay. You able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, annual report, they can give you options, like, you know, what are the tools that can be used. So, news releases, news announcements are very, very important. I hope you all know how important is news release. Okay, so that is where, like, you know, content is planned. Okay, what you want to execute, what you want to communicate is planned there in your news releases, and that is one of the very important tool. And then audio, video, and then visuals. Okay, cassettes, video tapes. It is just like, you know, your documentation. Okay, you have videos and audios about your organization that you have to keep it very. That is very important source of information. Okay, very commonly used tools and techniques. Okay, and then you have newsletters. Okay, newsletter and then house journal. Okay, newsletter. What is newsletter? Usually, journalism department, they have newsletters. Okay, they publish newsletter. What is newsletter?
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, usually newsletters, you know, they give the information or news regarding.
Mm.
It depends if they are bringing out a monthly newsletter.
Mm.
Some even bring out a weekly.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's regarding the events that have taken place within the organization over a period of time. If it's weekly or is it monthly basis, and if they are getting into anything new. Say, for example, if they're planning to expand their business or anything. So those are informed in the newsletters.
Very good. So so you can use that for, delivering information. That is one of the best tool, right? So newsletter, again, it is a kind of documentation for the organization. Plus, it is information that you're trying to give it to the outsiders. Sometimes it is inside, within organization also it becomes important. Why do you think the within organization newsletters become so important? Because knowing about my organization is the first thing that I have to do. Right, if I'm working in Prestige IIT College, so I should know what are the activities, what are the different clubs that we have. Okay, what are the, the community-based, research we are doing. Okay, so a lot of research are done by faculties. So what is it? So it is very important to know about our own organization. So sometimes you might even expect, like, questions about newsletter. Okay, but maybe topmost organization's newsletter also can be asked. I'm just giving you points, okay, and then you have press conference, and then press briefings, okay. So that is also very important. So usually you keep that also as a documentation part, and then you have meetings and conventions, opinion polls, attitude survey. Okay, this is very, very important. Attitude survey, and then you know, usually advertisements. Hello.
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
Okay. Oh, survey is done. Okay, the research team will be there in any company for that matter. There will be a research unit. Okay, so their job is to look into, do survey, and then see where their company stands. Okay, so like, you know, the brand that they are using, I mean, the product of the company. Okay, so they look into the surveys. They go to public. Okay, the research unit does this. And then this is a very important tool, like, you know, that you can use it. And then you have exhibits, displays, also very important. This is another tool that can be used. And then you have magazines, legislative testimony, okay, bulletins, okay. And then TV radio appearances. This is also very, very important. And then you have broadcasts, okay. If you have any broadcast related to your company, you can have it. And then you have demonstrations, open house tour, and then special events. So these are the tools that can be and techniques that can be used to deliver the organization communications. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is this tool also you keep in your mind, and then try to make out, like, you know, what are the major news letter, what is the major development that has happened in a company. Okay, for general paper also you might get it. Okay, so that is why I'm trying to, like, just, you know, look into different aspects. Okay, so then next you have principles and responsibilities. Okay, so there are certain principles and responsibilities of your PR. Okay, to serve management, and then to keep employees and the public informed, and to help the news media to do their job. Okay, so it is like, you know, there are many, they have listed out a lot of, principles under this major points. So what I'm trying to say is, like, you know, principles also becomes very important. So write down, like, you know, principles also. So when you have concepts like this, PR or development communication or whatever, nature and scope of, journalism, you have nature and scope. So please write, make points, like, you know, first thing that you please go through the question paper. Based on that, you just look into syllabus, and then based on that, you just make a point. Scope, objective, what are the bodies, and then what are the tools and techniques? I'm limiting myself to this PR. So what are the tools that has been used? Okay. And then you can just name some of the major, like, you know, a unique kind of tools that has been used by any organization. Please make a note of it. And then principles are very important. And then, I've already mentioned objectives. So this is how you can keep your area, like, you know, points, concepts in your mind, and then prepare based on that. Okay, so now what we can do is 1 minute. Okay, there is one particular PPT, sorry, about objective of PR. I've shared it. So I want you to derive one question from this paragraph. Okay, you can derive two questions, or you can derive three questions, or you can derive one question, but with options I want it. With options. I'll give you 2 to 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Is that fine? Hello? Before that, please let me know if you have any doubts with regard to PR. PR, when you look into the syllabus, there's no, like, you know, it's not as elaborate as other topics. So if you look into, so if you have any doubts, please ask me. Okay, we can discuss before you you could derive question. Is there any question with regard to PR or development communication? Because since it is last day. Carmel, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hello. My internet is not that stable. Some disturbance. Hello. Carmel, ma'am. Ma'am, feedback form is given to them or how is it?
No, ma'am.
No, okay.
No.
Okay. Hello. Yes, we can hear you, ma'am. Yes. If you have any doubts, we can just discuss if you have any questions. Hello. Selva sir, Charlotte sir, you can also share, like, you know, how you are preparing for your exams. Because for today, I'm done with it, like, you know, on the syllabus and the questions. Audio is not clear. Selva sir, can you please log in again? Re-log in so that your audio gets clear sometimes.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yeah. Is it audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Please.
Yeah, ma'am. Both the sessions are really good, ma'am. Actually, you have given the outline, actually, how to prepare. Yeah. What are the areas which we need to cover under PR and communication, and also on the previous day.
Okay,
so, sir. This will help us out to prepare more.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, sir. You have any questions? Like how you are trying to...
Yeah, basically, I go through all the contents and solving the papers. That is how I'm preparing. And And understanding the question, analyzing the question, that is very much important.
Okay.
And because in NET, they confuse us within the... If we read the question and go through each option and analyze it, then we surely get the answer. That is how I'm being preparing right now.
Okay.
So the answer is within. For example, the word sum may have some other meaning.
Yes.
For example, the question which you displayed on previous on the previous session, according to some critical philosopher, so that some means it does not speak about the general theme of any particular, it may be modern communication or it may be PR, anything. Okay. So that some few people would have said something else.
Yes.
But what we think is we connect PR and we easily connect with certain things which is related to PR.
Yes.
But when they say some, according to some PR philosopher or something, it means they have some other point of view of PR. Or PR, yeah.
Yes.
So
yes.
this is what they have the tricks in question answering.
Yes.
So
yes.
We need to read the questions very carefully and analyze it.
Mm.
That is what
and
I
also
have done.
Yeah. Reading this thing. What is it? Options is also equally important. I feel.
Yeah.
Personally feel because you don't know how they are connected to. Like you know, sometimes even both options, like you know, holds
seems to be right.
Good. Yeah, yeah. Seems to be right. And sometimes all the four seems to be right. So that is when
actually it is very easy to rule out two, but
yes,
certain times
yes.
The remaining two suits the questions. Both will
yes.
be. We feel that both the question, both the answers, options are right. So at that we have it is very tricky.
Very tricky. Yes. Yes.
Find it out.
That is possible only when you have hold on the subject
content. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Otherwise,
that's
is,
true.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Others, like any questions or if you want to share, you know, like, you know, you can give your tips, like how you are preparing. So that would help others also. Like, because the general guidelines I have given.
Ma'am, something that I felt that helped me before in clearing the net is that you need to stay up to date on what's happening
no.
around.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Yeah, so you need to stay up to date on what's happening. Stay informed, maybe reading the newspaper, going through what's happening recently. Because there are chances that you'll find something similar in your
So you should be one more, you know, very important tips that I want to give you. So I have already given it to you. You should class? You should think, you should live, you should eat, everything you should do. Like, you know, you just have to see where, from which corner you can expect questions. Okay. Anything that you read. Okay. You should be. Like, you know, able to derive and then just make a note of it. Okay. So that is very important actually. Till you crack your net exam. So that really helps you. I'm telling you, I'm not at all it's not a joke. You just, any content that you come across, you just make sure that you read it and then understand it and then derive a question and then just keep it. So constantly just MCQ questions, like, you know, if you type in Swayam assignment, sometimes it is available. So if you look into that also, like, you know, the options that they give, again, it is very tricky. Okay. So make sure that you just look into, you know, randomly, you just go through the MCQ questions of from any sources for that matter, and then try to crack those questions. So, and read options and then relate your options with your knowledge of what knowledge you have on particular content. So that I feel very, very important. Okay. So that's why I gave you the example of publicity. So terminologies, please be clear with. Okay. Especially in this PR, terminologies are very, very important. Okay. Newsletter, news release. Okay. What exactly it is. And then tools and then functions. These things you have to be very, very clear. And one more thing what we discussed, like, you know, one assertion deals with the scope and your reason deals with the nature. So try to know the subject. You should not have any kind of confusion there. You should be very clear with what the objective of PR and then scope of PR and nature of PR. So based on that, you can answer. I hope you're able to, like, you know, understand what I'm trying to say. So the basic of any foundation of any subject, it is like, you know, scope and then nature and then the principles, the usual principles and the functions and all of that. So if you understand that, if you have command over these things, you can develop your answers. You can analyze the answers in a better way. So it helps you in choosing the correct answer. That is what I'm trying to say. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much. And if you have any questions, you can always, you know, we can discuss. I have shared the number. And thank you so much. It was indeed nice, you know, talking to, interacting with you people. Thank you so much. Carmel, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for this session. I hope it was really interactive. Like, participants also share their opinions with us. So it's both helpful for everyone. So thank you, everyone, for this session. So we will be continuing with the next session. It starts from 4 p.m. So the ID will be shared in the WhatsApp group. You can log in with that ID. Thank you. If you have any feedback or anything, you can send to Mamta ma'am's number.
Yeah.
Or you can even share them. If you have any doubts or you need any materials, you can share it in the WhatsApp group as well.
Okay. Yes. I think they can do that.
Okay.
And thank you so much. And I wish you very all the best for all the, you know, participants here. I wish you all crack net at the earliest. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.